Hi guys, another gig log for you, and today I'm doing a gig in a marquee for about 450 people. Now, a bit of advice here. If you're doing, and I've said this a couple of times before, but you know, say it again. If you're doing any functions in marquees or outside, what you have to contend with is the fact that your PA system that sounds fantastic in a room, all of a sudden, the sound will disappear. Now this is one reason why when you go to big outside events, they have huge mounds of PA system. Admittedly, because logically they want it to be loud, but what happens is when you're in a room, the sound will leave your speakers, it will hit a back wall and bounce all... I tell you what, everything's bouncing around all over the place, which is not a good idea. Bouncing around in the back, but I did secure everything. I can't do anything, I'll explain in a second. So what you need to do is you need to make sure that you have sufficient sound. Now again, you know, when you're in a room, the sound bounces around, so 1,000 watts in a room for like 300 or 400 people will be fantastic. But you put 1,000 watts outside in a marquee and it will just vanish, it'll go nowhere. Now a lot of people seem to think, right, so I've got like 4 mid and top cabs and I'm doing a marquee, let's take loads of bass. Now, to a certain degree that's fine, but you're better off taking more mid and top. The reason being is because bass is omnidirectional and will travel no matter what. The high frequencies will tend to disappear more. You try this. When you're next in a marquee, you put your system straight up, turn it up, stand by the speakers, it'll be really loud. You move away 50 or 60 meters and it's like, it's there, you can hear it, but it's almost gone. Now, certain things will come apparent eventually, but I do not normally like to be late for functions, but the situation I'm in at the moment means that I had to do stuff and then dive in the van and rush to the gig. Now normally, it's now 3:45, normally I'd be there by now, but because of certain things, I've got to rush around like a stupid idiot now, which is, like I said, my life is crazy and surreal, and maybe one day I'll explain what's going on, and a lot of people are going to go, what the, but, this is the but, and this is what I'm about. If I can do this, you can too, alright, and it's about being strong, so, alright. Right, I suppose what I need to explain is, explain myself where the speakers are concerned. Now, I have got these, and Google them, they're fantastic cabs, they're RCF Event 6000, 215s, 8 and a 1 inch, and you can do what's called bi-amp them, whereby you can use just one amplifier to run them full range, or two amplifiers, bass, mid and top. Now, they're fantastic. What I have got, I'm running those off a StudioMaster 1100 watt side RMS, important RMS, 1100 watt side StudioMaster, and then I've also got the Cam Vortex 15s, but I've got four of those. I'm going to put two of those each side. So in essence, you're going to have three speakers each side running off two of the same amplifiers. Again, sometimes that's important to have the same amps. When you start going from your mixer into one amp of a certain make, then out of that into another amp of a certain make, another amp, and then into different speakers of all shapes and sizes. It's all over the place. Alright, again, slightly contradicting myself because I'm using Cam Vortex and RCF, but I am using the same amplifier, so everything there is perfectly matched. And what I will have to do prior to sort of turning things up is just sort out the levels on the amps to make sure that the speakers are working. Working A in tandem, but B, they're sort of singing as opposed to squawking. The last thing you want is them going, doesn't sound very good. There it is, guys. That's a rather large marquee. That's a huge marquee. Right, I'm going to do a tiny bit of filming now, but we are very, very busy. Now, the only problem we face is we're on uneven ground, which is an absolute pain in the ass. Plus the fact, in this part of the marquee, I don't know if you can see, blurry bits. There's the marquee, and then we're in the dark area. so it's pitch black in there and it's very difficult to see what you're doing. In fact, it's exceedingly difficult to see what you're doing. There's a lot of people here today, 450 in total. Right, here we are. We're slowly setting up and it's looking really cool. One thing I really do enjoy, I thoroughly enjoy this, is when you go to a new place and you set stuff up, basically what you're doing is you're almost, in a sense, you're setting up a nightclub and every single place is different. It will always be different. Now check this out, Scrim King. All right, now look what I've done. Normally, you put those guys on tripods. I've got framework around the DJ console and there you go. That's where the DJ is, just in there. Now to me, that looks pretty good. Also there is a black Scrim King and that's covering the tripod for the screen itself. That laser's pointing in the wrong direction. That guy over there doesn't know what the hell he's doing. And I'm knackered. Right, here we go, we're nearly done. Got to put some, got some pin spots I've got on the Scrim Kings either side, light those up. I need to centralise that guy, because I don't know if you can see, it's sort of bigger at the top and smaller at the bottom, which just means that I've got to level the projector at the back. But of course, you know, the whole bloody ground's wonky all over the place, so what I do suggest is if you're coming and working in the likes of a marquee where you're on wobbly ground, it's always a good idea to bring lots of cardboard and bits of wood that just handy to put underneath speakers. And maybe if you're, you know, if you have to have everything perfect, maybe a good idea to bring a spirit level as well, so everything's sort of spot on, you know. Got some lights to turn on over there as well. We'll put the lights on over there as well, Dave, yeah? All right, there you go, that looks pretty good. I've got the they're American DJ pin spots, and I've got those behind the Scrim King. What I've done though is I've taken the lenses out, so the angle of light is a lot broader. When you've got the lens in it, it's more of a pin spot. Now that just basically shines up a greater area. Again, with reference to the video screen, I mean, the irony is there's quite a few lights here, but of course, with not much smoke, you can't see much of, you can't really see much of the effect, can you? But once you've got the smoke out, it's a lot better. But then again, of course, the emphasis is on the video as opposed to loads of lights. So what do you think of the show so far then, Dave? It looks all right, doesn't it? It looks good. Guests are arriving, a bit of champagne, and chilling out. Okay, we've got the RCFs next to the Cam Vortex. I've put them all together because they'll all work in tandem, so you get a better sound. Bearing in mind, we've got 815s, 815s, 6 1-inch compression drivers, and 2 8-inch mid-range. So, and I'll tell you what, it sounds sweet. Well, no, you can say what you want, but you can just say hello and hi if you want to.
Hello and hi.
So, I must say your attire looks wonderful.
Thank you very much.
So do you think there'll be quite a few people there like this, yeah?
Let's hope so, yes, we don't feel
it. Excellent. Bit of a dance later on then, do you think?
Yeah, definitely.
Right, you're in then. You're in. Okay, thanks.
You are.
Right, this part of the video goes out to Tim. I'm not going to say anything else, David is.
Right then, Tim. This here is not Foster's. I don't know what it is, but I'm telling you what, I've had 2 sips and I'm on the verge of being rutted. It is seriously strong
it
stuff.
It tastes beautiful though, doesn't it?
It absolutely
It's proper strong. Real stuff.
Proper beer. That
beautiful. What's your name, sir?
Pete Thorpe.
And what's your website?
It's www.petethorpe.co.uk.
Excellent.
Yes.
Are you absolutely knackered?
Well, not absolutely knackered, no.
There you go. I'm going to wipe the window with a sock. They think I'm joking. Ah, it's a sock. Brilliant. So, it's fun tonight, wasn't it?
Interesting, yeah.
Would you like to explain what happened? Oh, God, blimey.
Do you really want to know?
Well,
yeah. Well, basically kicked off a little bit, so decided to call it a night, basically.
Yeah, tell me about it. Well, I mean, is there a dip there? Yeah, there's a dip. Well, what happened was, it got a bit silly, didn't it?
It did.
I think there was far too many people drinking Coca-Cola and ice pops and stuff, wasn't there?
Far too many.
What happened was, where the screen is. There was a guy who was helping out, partially sort of running the joint, as it were, and I didn't notice. Well, no, first of all, I beg your pardon, there was a couple of lads who knocked into the screen, and it didn't go flying, it just went fluh, didn't it?
Yeah.
It just went fluh, right? Just bear that in mind. And then this guy turns up and stands near sort of the screen and whatnot, and just moves people out of the way. And then about, bearing in mind I finished at 3 o'clock, 20 to 3, everything went flying, and I mean literally flying. The screen, bosh, where I had the projector, shh, like that, and there was a fight, and the idiots. Now, under normal circumstances, what you tend to do is, if people are with your gear, and there's one or two acting a prat, you push them out of the way and tell them to fuck, go away. But there was half a dozen of them. Well, there was, what, four or five, I think. They were just completely pissed out of their heads. And to be quite honest, the way it looked, it's like, just don't get involved. Just don't do it, you know? Now, a couple of pointers here. One is that maybe, I don't know, maybe some people do this. And if you do, it's a bloody good idea. Get some sort of, not necessarily a contract, what do you think, Dave? Something that stipulates that if there is any damage,
that's right, yeah,
it should be paid for. In other words, you're there to give a service, your equipment is exceedingly expensive, and you are not, under any circumstance, going to go to a particular event, have some pisshead break something, and then think, hey, I'll pay for it, I don't mind. So, good idea, get some sort of a contract. Now, luckily, because it was quite... it was a good event, that's all I'm going to say, a very good event, and the organisers were exceedingly apologetic and have basically said, any breakages, let us know, and it will be paid for. I mean, my first concern when everything went flying was like, projector, it's like, oh, freaking heck, because it's like 500, 600 quid's worth, you know. Damage I can see is one of the T-bars for the stand that housed the screen has gone a bit numpty. It's looking a bit icky wicky sick.
Leaning into the wind a bit.
Like Dave said, it's leaning to the wind. I think a couple of lights went as well, but I don't know. I don't, to be quite honest, I don't think there's much damage. I would say the major damage is the fact that the night was stopped, not necessarily too early, but early enough for people to go, we don't want idiots there again. So hopefully, if they find out the idiots who started the fight, they may say to them very politely, don't bother coming again, otherwise we'll shove a rather large object up your backside. Sideways! Hey! Sideways! So, all I can say, oh dear, you've got to laugh, you have to though, don't you? If you did laugh, you bloody cry. So what I will say is that, oh dear, camera's going for a button. What I will say is, it's always a good idea to make sure, no, I'm sorry, yeah, that you have Not necessarily, well, all right, logically, you need public liability insurance. That's very important, because if someone falls over a cable of yours, then you are in the shtuck. But maybe what you should do, and what I'm going to do from now on, is go up to the management or the person who's organising it and say, with the greatest respect, if there are any problems and any of your guests break any of the appliances that I brought, then it has to be paid for. So, word of warning. And in Dave's final words,
practice and enjoy.
Thank you.
Where's the button? There it is.